Welcome to Your Voice, a program for you to see how your voice is being heard in the New York State Senate involving the Syracuse community. I'm Julia Locandy, and today I'm with Senator John DeFrancisco. Good to see you, Senator.
And good to see you.
You know, the Senate has a Woman of Distinction ceremony, and that was last night. And it gives senators a chance to recognize standout women in their district. Do you want to take a look at the clip from last night?
Yeah, that's great.
From Senator DeFrancisco's district, Nancy Cronin. Nancy Cronin has distinguished herself through effective leadership, outstanding character, and community service. She is the Director of Development and Public Relations for Arise Child and Family Services, where she's devoted to ensure everyone has a chance to learn and thrive, standing up for the rights of people with disabilities. Ms. Cronin has also played a vital role in the progress of numerous local programs to prevent youth violence, help revitalize city neighborhoods, provide quality, affordable housing, food, and clothing. Congratulations. So tell us more about Nancy Cronin.
Nancy's a real community activist in a good sense. You know, some people like to make a lot of noise and like to agitate. And claim themselves to be an activist. She does things. She gets things done for the betterment of the community. I first met her way back when there was a program in the city of Syracuse called Weed and Seed. And the concept was you would weed out some of the bad apples in the neighborhood by getting the police in there trying to control the crime and then seed it with programs in order to make the communities better. And she did an incredible job for the city. She does an incredible job with. But she's always working with youth or the disabled or people in need and doing the right thing. Presently, she's with Arise, and this is a program for the disabled in the city of Syracuse County of Onondaga. Great program. They do a wonderful job, and she loves it. This is exactly what she likes to do, and she will be successful and has been successful at that as everything else.
Tell us more about the Woman of Distinction ceremony.
Well, we started it actually 16 years ago. It doesn't seem that. It's just unbelievable how time flies. But each year, each senator has the opportunity to honor someone from their district. And over those many, many years, there have been great people and great things are expressed about them at this ceremony. But it's even more than that. I've talked to some people who have gotten the Woman of Distinction Award in the past, and they network with people they've met at this function because there's similar interests for some of the people who maybe from Long Island do the same type of work of somebody from Central New York. And they network with each other and provide these bonds and this assistance that they otherwise would not have gotten. So, it's terrific and it's fun. It's interesting because we had a young high school girl, and we had an elderly lady. I think she was 94, 95, something like that. That's been volunteering forever and still volunteering at her local library. I mean, it's interesting and it's some very heartwarming stories, you know, where a death, for example, of a lacrosse player, this woman's son, got hit in the chest at the right time, exactly right instant, and the ball hit him in the chest and he died. They couldn't revive him. And she parlayed that into a bill that became law that requires defibrillators in the high schools and I think in the other schools as well. So a very, very horrible thing turned into a positive. And it was mentioned that since the bill became law, 57 lives were saved because the defibrillators were right there. So it's interesting, it's very heartwarming, and it's a program that's everybody loves every year.
Yeah, the women are examples for us all, and the stories are really great to hear.
Correct.
So the woman you inducted last year, Colleen Mastine, she unfortunately has passed away way too early. Tell us about the recent tribute.
Well, there's a place called Casey's Place that we help get funding for, and basically it's a respite facility for kids with multiple handicaps, wheelchair-bound, various cerebral palsy, all different types of multiple disabilities. And obviously kids like that don't get invited to too many birthday parties and things like that, so this is a place where they can go. And secondly, not only for their social socialization, which is remarkable. If anybody goes there, they can see what I'm talking about. But also, having a child with this many disabilities is very taxing on the parents, obviously. And this gives the parents an opportunity to get some respite from the 24-hour care. Even if you have help, it's always around the clock. And it's been extremely successful. And Colleen Mastine, when she was in my office, she did the hard part. I got the easy part, got some funding to help build a facility. But she had to get through all the government bureaucracy because these children are entitled to various state funding for various programs and had to make sure those programs at Casey's Place fit in with the funding and that funding stream to make it operate actually happened. They were entitled to it anyway, but it was difficult to figure out how to structure it. And she was being honored at Casey's Place, and it was a very emotional tribute. And her untimely death, it was an accident. She fell and hit just the right way, and just a terrible thing. We miss her a lot as a person. My wife went to school with her since grammar school. But also, we've got other projects going on now where we could definitely use her the same help. And so she was a remarkable woman as well.
Yeah, a woman of distinction. A
woman of distinction.
So I want to move on now to, there was a National Science Bowl. There were winners in your district. Tell us what this competition is all about.
Well, that's exactly what it is. It's knowledge of science. It's not creating a robot or something. It's a knowledge of science. And the Syracuse Academy of Science, which happens to be a charter school, they put a team together and they came in first place in the national competition, which is absolutely remarkable. And one, for example, would be the expert in geology. One would be the expert in physics. One would be whatever specific topic. And they would compete against other schools throughout the country. And when you think of where this school came from and where it is now, it wasn't existing about 7 or 8 years ago. And there's a lot of opposition by public school people that you shouldn't have charter schools. And they get their students not by cherry picking, getting the best students. They get their students by a lottery. And so with the same type of student, the same levels of students, they're winning national competitions. So it can be done. It can be done. Kids can learn if under the correct atmosphere. And they've done a wonderful job. And we talked in a prior program about teacher evaluations and the testing and whether they're too hard or the social esteem. You know, we got to get down to the nitty-gritty and teach kids what they need to know. And if you do, you'll get remarkable results.
Right. Some high school kids from Liverpool came to Albany to visit you. Tell us about that.
Well, we get groups like this all the time that come in to see us. And they were mostly from their student council. And the student council are the leaders of the school. And we always meet with them. We get a photo at this million-dollar staircase. And interestingly enough, two of my current employees have photos with me on the million-dollar staircase when they were in elementary school, okay? So it's kind of, I tell the kids that, they get a kick out of it, but they ask me some good questions. You know, they obviously are interested in government, interested in politics, and I think it was a good experience for them and for all students that get the opportunity with their class to come to Albany.
Yeah, another recent trip was from West Genesee High School. They had the opportunity to ask you questions in the State House as well.
Yeah, same thing, and same opportunity that they have as other kids have. And the schools, you know, call our office. We set up the whole day for them, including a tour of the Capitol. And in fact, the Nancy Cronin's family came to the event last night for the Woman of Distinction. And she took a tour, and she was amazed. And after the program, her family came for the program, so we kind of walked around. She was telling her family more about the Capitol than I knew about the building itself. But so and they get a chance. We get a chance to talk, and each of the classes that come through, and it's a great opportunity for me to also. Meet the students and hopefully get them interested in being leaders in the future.
So an 11-year-old girl from your district, she took home the national first place trophy in a soccer shootout. Let's watch your resolution of her achievement.
Madam President, this was previously adopted, and we wanted to make sure that Mari was able to be here to see the recognition that she's receiving from the state Senate. And sometimes people kind of groan when I stand up because we have all the athletes in Central New York. And we feel sorry for the rest of the areas, but we want to keep showcasing those athletes. Mari won the Elks Area 1 National Shootout, soccer shootout. She, in October of last year, she, in Poughkeepsie, New York, she got her ticket to the Nationals by beating Maine, New Hampshire, Vermont, Connecticut, Massachusetts, and Rhode Island, almost all of the original 13 states. But she went further than that and won the national shootout thereafter. 11-year-old girl who I understand is a good student, and she's going to get to be a better student, correct? As she goes through the rest of her schoolwork. And I just wanted to honor Mari for her accomplishment. It's an incredible accomplishment when anyone at any age, let alone 11, wins a national competition. So congratulations. And she's here with her parents, Ron and Michelle, her sister, Veronica, who didn't win a shootout yet, but maybe later, grandparents, Joe and Mary Ann Grantide, Ron and Kathy DeToto, the whole family's here, and cousin Megan skipped school today, too. So congratulations.
So we have a picture, and I want to ask you a question about it, because just by looking at it, I figured that you were showing them a video of your grandson, Ogden, playing soccer.
That's,
am I right?
That's exactly what it was, because she's a soccer player, and there's a great short video, and it was kind of interesting, and they got a kick out of it.
Get a goal in that goal. Let's see you do it. Can you do it?
Yeah!
Okay, let's see the determination. Let's do it. On your marks, get set, go. Get it out of the weeds. Good. Good save. Oh, you got it. Goal! Goal, 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 goal. Yes!
As you do every year, you go out to opening day baseball ceremonies in your district.
Right. And that brings back great memories because I played baseball all the way through college. And to see the kids starting off their season, it's really a wonderful thing. It's a great, great program, Little League. Last year I went, and this year again I'm going to personally go. I'm going to Williamsport to watch the Little League World Series. And it's great. It's a wonderful day, and it's fun. I throw out the first pitch. Usually I make it to the catcher. One time this weekend, though, I threw it too low, and it was bounced in the dirt. Very, very embarrassed, but it's fun. I enjoy being with the kids. And, you know, a lot of people talk about a legislator, that what they do is they make laws and they try to solve problems. But you have to be, and I enjoy it. That's why I enjoy what I'm doing. There's so many different events, so many things going on that are fun, so many uplifting things, even though you hear about all the bad stuff all the time. And I think it's part of my job as a state senator to try to be a role model and try to be seen by those kids and trying to relate to them. And that's what I try to do.
You mentioned you played baseball, and we have some pictures. Tell us about these pictures.
Well, a guy who played third base, Herm Card, when I played at Syracuse, he had these pictures. I don't know where he got them from, but that year I played second base. I usually played shortstop. And Rick Quesada, he played ball in pro football after that in the Canadian League. And these were a group of players from Syracuse. That are still, three of them are still in Syracuse. One, unfortunately, is deceased. Very good looking group of kids.
Yeah, they are. So I understand that there is a village in your district that's turned 200 years old.
The village of Manlius, absolutely. And they had a nice celebration. Many were there. That's the new mayor, and everybody. Most people had the traditional garb on, and it was fun. They did a very good job.
Great to see you again, Senator. Thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator John DeFrancisco. We hope you join us next week for additional information, defrancisco.nysenate.gov.